pray. May my words and our thoughts be pleasing to you, O Lord, our Maker and Redeemer. Amen. If you have the hot pink sheet in your bulletin, it has some sermon notes and some place for you to write on if you want to make some notes. But we're looking at our reading, as we said, from Philippians. And we have a Greek word there, koinonia. And that word means partnership. In our text, in version, the NRSV, the New Revised Standard Version, verse 5, instead of saying partnership, says sharing in. I like to read it with the partnership in there, so it would say, because of your partnership in the gospel from the first day until now. And then in verse 7, the NRSV says, for all of you share. They use the word share for partnership. But I would prefer the Greek, all of you became partners in God's grace together with me. Koinonia means to come into communion for fellowship, to become a sharer, to be made a partner, to enter in a fellowship, to enter in a partnership. And in Philippians, there's a special partnership that exists between Paul and the Philippian church. This partnership helped expand the gospel in that area of the world. Paul was a missionary that went out to spread the gospel, but his home base was in Philippi. The Philippian church helped him to do his work. They supported him both with money and care and people to go out and do his work. So that was a special partnership. And in fact, as Paul says, that our partnership is with each other and in between churches and missionary society or organizations. He says also in 1 Corinthians 1:9, we are called into a partnership with Jesus Christ. Our partnership is with Jesus. The main emphasis of Paul's letter to the Philippian church was to encourage them to be citizens of heaven. And this was made evident by their growing commitment to serve God and serve one another in this partnership. So Paul was especially pleased by how this church joined him in his partnership to evangelize that area of the world, his missionary activities. And here in Zion, you guys have many different partnerships. One of your partnerships is Joyful Noise. We partner with Joyful Noise so that boys and girls can have pre-readiness classes for school, getting them ready for kindergarten and first grade. But it also gives a church a chance to talk in the lives of these precious children. It also gives us a chance to show God's love to their parents. It's an important partnership of Zion. We have a partnership with Trinity Church. I'm part of that partnership because I'm down there most times, at least 3 Sundays a month and during the week, to reach out to that community with God's love. So Zion has an important partnership with Trinity. The Girl Scouts and the Boy Scouts, we have a long tradition here of working with the Scouts. They do a lot for us. We do a lot for them. That's a partnership. The ELCA, we have partnership with the ELCA. One of them is God's Work, Our Hands, where we work in our community. But that's also much broader than just us. It goes across the country and around the world with the ELCA, the Evangelical Lutheran Church of America, which we're partners with, we're a member of. With York Rescue Mission, just Sunday the 22nd, our partnership with them, our junior and senior high class with their teachers and some volunteers went down there to serve, well, they actually got the food, made the food, and served the food down at the York Rescue Mission. Here's a picture of Hannah showing God's love to a man while he eats at the York Rescue Mission. Zion and you have many more partnerships also. I just highlighted some of the partnerships that we have. Partnership does not exist as an end in itself. It exists for the purpose of advancing the kingdom of God. Partnership advances the kingdom of God either better or faster than we could alone. So an injured soldier could crawl to a hospital, that'd take a long time. Or one person could try to carry him, but he'd have to rest in that. But in a partnership, we can get them there faster and better doing that four-hand method. That's a partnership. Partnership advances the kingdom of God either better or faster than one could alone. In Philippians, Paul talks about partnerships producing a harvest of righteousness. And in that case, Paul was going out and producing a harvest of righteousness as people came to the Lord through his preaching and his missionary activity. But he also means that for him himself and for his partner, the Philippian church, that they were harvesting a harvest of righteousness in their own heart. In our partnership, we're serving God and harvesting righteousness even for ourselves. In the gospel reading from today, from Luke, we saw John the Baptist. And he's in partnership with God to prepare the way of the Lord. And in this Advent season, the theme for this week is preparation, preparing. We're preparing ourselves for the coming of Jesus Christ. That's preparation. That's part of partnership, is preparing the way of the Lord in the world here. Zion is in partnership with other churches, with the Lower Susquehanna Synod, with the ELCA, and other organizations to advance the kingdom of God and to prepare the way of the Lord. There are three key points in a Christian partnership. The first point is partners have a common vision. Partners have a common vision or purpose. One of those is showing and sharing God's love to a hurting world. That's why we partner with other people, to show God's love and share God's love to a hurting world. The second thing is partnership is mutual in nature. Each partner has something to give. Each partner has something to receive. It's mutual in nature. And third, partners have different rules. Both partners are important for the success of the common vision or the common purpose. We need both partners together to do it. I'm going to show you some pictures of partnership, which will hopefully explain what I'm talking about in a Christian partnership. The first one is of a cow and a farmer. In this partnership, one gives everything, and the other partner takes everything. The cow gives, and the farmer takes. It's a partnership. No question, the cow gets food and lodging, and the farmer gets milk, but it's not the best partnership. It's not what I'm talking about in a Christian partnership. We also have this one of the horse and rider. One partner, the horse, goes wherever the other partner, the rider, directs it. And we've been in those partnerships where somebody controls everything we do. It's not really a partnership. That's not what we're talking about in a Christian partnership. A better picture might be the oxen plowing, equally doing the work together, and they're being driven by God. The plow person could be God in the back, and the oxen works together to pull that plow. And what makes that possible is the yoke. And so we look at the yoke as the yoke of Christ. That yoke makes us equal. Even if we're unequal partners, the yoke makes us equal. One church might have a lot of money. One church might not have any money but has a building. They can work together, and that yoke makes them equal. I saw this in Egypt when there was a camel and a donkey in the field pulling a plow. The camel was gigantic. The donkey was small, but they had a yoke on there, and that yoke made it possible that they both, the yoke of Christ, pull together. I think this is a good picture of partnership, but it's not the best. I think for a Christian partnership, a bride and a bridesmaid is a better symbol of what we're talking in partnership. A bridesmaid. What is a bridesmaid's job? Anybody? What's a bridesmaid's job? To? Anybody? Help who? The bride. Help the bride. Make the bride look lovely. Do all the little details to lift the bride up. And I think that's the partnership we need to be in as a church. As we partner with other organizations, other churches, as we partner in our own organization, we have to be the one that lifts the other one up, preparing the other partner for the coming of the Lord. I think that is the best. Think of a bridesmaid when you think of partnership. That's what you should do with your partner. You should lift that person up to make them perfect, to make them without blemish, to help them succeed in life. Preparing other partners for the coming of our Lord. Partnership exists for the purpose of advancing the kingdom of God. Like Paul and the Philippians, in producing a harvest of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ, like John the Baptist and God preparing the way of the Lord, our partnership is with Jesus, the Son of God. He is always with us. Jesus, this partnership with Jesus sustains us today in our service of advancing the kingdom with our partners. Jesus sustains us in doing that. It also guarantees us that we will join him in the future, in eternity, because our partnership is with Jesus. Amen.